The use of object orientation and object-oriented concepts led to what we call OOAD, Object-Oriented Analysis and Design. OOAD is a software engineering approach whose main characteristic is to model a software system as a group of interacting objects. And we'll see what that means. In particular, in this lesson, we will specifically focus on the first part of this, object-oriented analysis, which is a requirements analysis technique that concentrates on modeling real-world objects. And as I usually like to do, I would like to start by providing some historical perspective on object-oriented analysis to better understand how we went from a function-centric world to a data-centric world. And several people contributed to this shift in perspective, but I'd like to mention a few that were particularly influential. Starting from James Rumble, which in the 90s developed an integrated approach to object-oriented modeling with three main aspects. A data aspect, so the modeling was based on using an extended version of entity relationship diagrams to describe classes and inheritance. So that's what was called the object model. And the second aspect has to do with functions. So data flow diagrams were used to represent the functional aspects of the system, where each function was then becoming a method in a class. So this is what is called the functional model. So object model and functional model. The third model in Rumble's methodology had to do with control. So it was representing the dynamic aspects of a system. And it used the state machines, which we will cover in more detail, to represent how a system would evolve, going from one state to the other based on what happened to the system. These three models together represented what was called the object modeling technique, or OMT. And OMT, combined with contribution from several people, and in particular Jacobson and Butch, evolved into what we call the Unified Modeling Language, which is UML, which is probably the modeling language that most of you are familiar with. UML extends OMT by providing more diagrams and a broader view of a system from multiple perspectives. So in the second part of the lesson, we will cover some of these diagrams in details. But before that, I'd like to talk a little bit more about object-oriented analysis and how we can perform it.